Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Perhaps this is your first time joining us. We extend a warm welcome to you and trust that you're blessed with what you hear today. We want to begin with prayer. There is so much to pray about. We want to continue to pray for our nation. We want to continue to pray for our local community and region. We want to pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. And we want to pray for our brothers and sisters around the world. Perhaps you have a special unspoken request. This is a perfect time to make that known unto God. Let's pray together. Father, we love you. We praise you. We worship you. There's nobody like you. We thank you for the abundance of all things. Father, we pray for your continued influence of the Word and the Spirit upon the direction of our nation. We also pray for the opening of doors of utterance for our local community and region. We also pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church and pray that you'll open up the windows of heaven and pour out your virtue, your presence, and your power. And lastly, Father, we pray for our brothers and sisters around the world, missionaries, their families, and our brethren. Pray that you build a hedge of protection around them. We ask all this in the name above every name, the name of Jesus Christ, and everybody said amen. I want to direct your attention to important passage of scripture found in the book of 1 Samuel, chapter number 15. 1 Samuel 15, we're going to begin reading in verse number 32. Then said Samuel, bring ye hither to me Agag, the king of the Amalekites. And Agag came unto him delicately, and Agag said, surely the bitterness of death is past. And Samuel said, as thy sword hath made women childless, so shall thy mother be childless among women. And Samuel hewed Agag in pieces before the Lord in Gilgal. I want to entitle this morning, I am here to kill an Amalekite. I am here to kill an Amalekite. This story of Samuel once again meeting with Saul, and the story of Saul, the larger picture of Saul, is one of the most negative and sad stories in the entirety of the Word of God. Saul started out as an incredible image of God's image for his people, broad-shouldered, large, tall, strong, valiant. But Saul's character eroded to the place where God actually repented that he had called Saul to be and make him king. But in one final test for Saul, Saul had an opportunity to finally get himself right and get himself right in the sight of God. God gave him a job to do, a job that was a long time coming. In fact, look at the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 24. Deuteronomy chapter number 25, verse number 17. Remember what Amalek did unto thee by the way when ye were come forth out of Egypt, how he met thee by the way and smote the hindmost of thee, even all that were feeble behind thee, when thou was faint and weary, and he feared not God. Therefore it shall be, when the Lord thy God hath given thee rest from all thine enemies round about in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee for an inheritance to possess it, that thou shalt blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. Thou shalt not forget it. You may remember that the nation of Israel, coming out of Egyptian bondage, crossing over on dry shod, the very first enemy that they are confronted with is the Amalekites. They are the descendants of Esau, like the Edomites that became enemies of God's people. There when the nation of Israel was hot and weary and thirsty, Amalek and the Amalekites came down. And as it's already mentioned in the book of Deuteronomy, they slew the feeble and the weak, and they drove them off of water. God said, I'm going to get you for that. I'm going to get you for that. I'll not forget it. And the day is going to come, I'm going to find a man. I'm going to find somebody that can do this job and is going to take care of you. And in a last opportunity for King Saul, with all the bumps in the road and all the faults of his character and all of his limitations as a king, he is given an opportunity to come through valiantly and to perform the word of the Lord. And it's given unto Saul to go and absolutely destroy all of the Amalekites. Well, you know the story, how that Saul went and they kept the choice, the sheep, the cattle, and they kept King Agag alive. In this pitiful dialogue that takes place between the prophet and the king, he is pressed. Saul is pressed. Why did you not do the word of the Lord? And Saul continued to respond, I have done the will of God. I have performed the word of the Lord. And finally, the prophet says, well, I hear cattle, I hear sheep, I hear animals. What's going on here? Oh, it was the people's fault. I didn't want to deny the people. God cannot use a leader that is afraid of the people, because there was a historic job to do. And Saul failed to carry out the word of the Lord. In a bigger biblical typology, the Amalekites represent sin. They represent sin in an individual's life, sin that will keep us from the refreshment of that God has provided for us when we're weary in our spiritual journey. A spiritual enemy that will constantly be at war with us that needs to be vanquished. God marked this sin. God marked the Amalekites and said, I am going to blot out the memory of them forever. And of course, Saul failed to do that. And so the prophet appears with the anointing of the Spirit of God, with God's word in his heart and upon his lips. And that's the way that a prophet needs to be. If others will not get the job done, if others in other capacities will not get the job done, the prophet, the man of God, must get the job done. And so he takes a sword and he hacks Agag into pieces right in front of Saul, as if to say, I will do what you would not do. I will do what you did not do. Make no mistake about it. The man of God, under the direction of the Spirit of God and the Word of God, will take care of sin in your life if you'll let him. That's right. Sins that have kept you chained, sins that have kept you from realizing your fullest potential, sins that have gnawed away at your victory, sins that have kept your tears flowing down your cheeks. The man of God is here to kill an Amalekite. God bless you. Thank you for joining us here this morning. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow.